Hello, and thank you for watching this talk. My name is Amal Nanavati, and today I'll be presenting our work in modeling human helpfulness with individual and contextual factors for robot planning. Consider a mobile robot in an office building. The robot might get lost, might get knocked over, or might be asked to go to a location it hasn't heard of. In such situations, the robot can ask for human help. Yet, the question of who and when to ask for help is nuanced. Past work has revealed that a robot that asks for help too much could lead to people getting annoyed, as can a robot that asks for help at the wrong times. Yet, a robot that doesn't ask for help enough may be unable to complete its tasks efficiently. In this work, we ask, how can a robot model human helpfulness in order to balance the dual objectives of efficiently completing its tasks and minimizing the number of times it asks for help? We consider two types of factors when modeling human helpfulness: individual factors and contextual factors. Individual factors are unchangeable and often unobservable characteristics of the human. Contextual factors can change over time and embed the human within their broader physical and temporal context. Past work in human helpfulness has focused on individual factors, and work in human interruptibility has focused on contextual factors. We bring these two together. Our key insight is that effectively planning for a task that involves bystander help requires disaggregating individual and contextual factors and explicitly reasoning about uncertainty over individual factors. First, let's consider why it's important to disaggregate individual and contextual factors. Consider the time when a robot needs help finding a room, and consider two potential helpers, one who is not latently helpful and the other who is. If the robot encounters human 1 in the hallway, its model should predict that they're unlikely to help it. If it encounters human 2 when they're on a break, it should predict that they're likely to help. However, if it encounters human 2 when they're busy, it should recognize that even though they're a latently helpful individual, due to contextual factors, they're unlikely to help at the moment. Second, let's consider why it's important to explicitly reason about the uncertainty over individual factors. As I mentioned earlier, the individual factor we consider is the human's latent helpfulness, which is unobservable. However, it can be inferred from repeated interactions with the same person. By explicitly reasoning about its uncertainty over latent helpfulness, the robot can take information-gathering actions and gradually converge its belief of the human's latent helpfulness. Our domain is an online virtual office environment, where interactions are designed to mimic a robot asking bystanders in an office building for help. The user is told that they control an IT administrator who's under time pressure to complete their main task of maintaining computer software. A mail delivery robot is also operating in the same office building, and periodically it asks users for help going to its destination. We use this domain to collect data on users' help-giving behaviors and use that data to train a model. The model takes in the human's latent helpfulness, their busyness at that time, and the robot's past frequency of asking them for help. Latent helpfulness is an individual factor, and busyness and frequency are contextual factors. Latent helpfulness is inferred from the history of past interactions with that person. The model then outputs the predicted probability of that human helping the robot. We use generalized linear mixed models with a logistic link function. GLMM enables us to account for both the observed contextual factors, but also the unobserved individual factor of latent helpfulness. This graph of our learned model illustrates the importance of accounting for both individual and contextual factors. The x-axis is human busyness, and the y-axis is their predicted probability of helping. Users span the gamut, from those who are never willing to help the robot to those who are willing to help even as they get busier. However, a version of this model that only accounts for contextual factors, the black line, would be unable to capture that variability in human behavior. We then integrate our model into a Bayes Adaptive Markov Decision Process Planning framework and run another user study comparing our model to baseline models. In this user study, users interact with a robot that is autonomously determining whether or not to ask for help using a human help model. Our results show that our proposed model, the hybrid model, outperforms both baselines in terms of cumulative reward by a factor of 1.5x. When we break that down, our model was able to receive more help on average while asking for help 1.2x fewer times. In other words, our model was better able to predict when the user would be willing to help and chiefly ask for help at those times. In summary, in this paper, we developed a model of human help learned from user data that disaggregates individual and contextual factors. We then integrate the model into a planning framework and demonstrate it in a user evaluation that significantly outperforms baselines. We recommend you read the paper for more details.